the Boss Man Show, calling the coach Rob Jeter, Western Illinois, 3-0 on the year. Big game on Saturday against DePaul. He's happy in Macomb, Illinois. It's my man, Rob Jeter. How you doing, man?
I'm doing good. How you doing?
Coach, it's been good, man. Been a while since we talked last April, man, during the pandemic. So happy to talk to you again, man. Let me ask you, Coach, how has program changed for you since last time we talked over a year ago, man?
Yeah, well, shoot, a lot has changed, right? We're actually trying to get back to a almost normal life, right? We've had a full year under our belt with a team, a group of guys, and now we've added some key pieces. So it's almost like it's back to normal. It's going good.
I hear that, Coach. And I'm going to ask you, man, having a true spring this time around, really implement your system, get guys in shape, a true summer. How key was, in your mind, has it been for you all to be 3-0 now, be going on the road, beating Nebraska, getting a home win last night, giving your guys confidence after getting your system for fully a whole year and to have to actually train with you, not have to do over Zoom and do things on their own? How has that been for you? How key has that been for your start so far, man?
Well, it's been critical for it. I think if you would have asked every coach that before the pandemic, right, it might have been split. Like, okay, do we really need a spring? Some of these guys need a little bit of a break. The summer, you know, we're really grinding these guys too much in the summer. You know, do we need less time in the summer? I think a lot of us would have, you know, had some questions about that. But having gone through it through the pandemic, and then seeing, and then for me, seeing how a team can perform without it, oh, it's absolutely necessary. And I would go even further to say we need more time with our guys. For my program, especially starting a new one, it was critical that we had a spring, critical that we had a summer where you can implement your standards. You can start to get guys, hold them accountable on all those little things that you really want to drive home. Because we say it all the time. It's like a cliche, right? The little things matter. And you got to take care of the little things. But it is so important to do that. And you do those things in the spring and summer. And when you're getting ready to start in the fall, you probably have a good 3 to 4 weeks to do it. But then now you have to do game prep. And it's scouting report. It's adjustments. And you can't build a program off adjustments. You have to have some type of standard, some type of foundation to your program. That's what you get in the spring and summer.
And Coach, when I played ball myself, when I was in Atlanta by myself, I wasn't as productive as I was in Nashville with my guys at Tennessee State. So I feel like for me, being around those your guys, they pushing the weight room, when you're doing individual drills, trying to get better, or me catching the balls for me, other guys on your coach taking jumpers and doing things. I feel like having that competitive juice with your guys to push you and build that camaraderie as well, because when things get tough, you know, this man got my back. Well, this guy has my back. So how big that camaraderie drew our guys built this spring and summer and in the fall as you get to play these games now?
Yeah, you're talking about that brotherhood, right? You're talking about that, you know, and everyone is in this, we're connected. People say that, use that word a lot. And it's true. When you're working out together, you're feeding off each other's energy and you're picking guys up when they come in some days and they're not ready to go. You can pick them up as well. And you can kind of cancel out all the other noise. And the one thing I tell my guys all the time is that the most difficult part for them is that they have so many voices. You know, you've got family, you've got trainers, and some of them have a couple different trainers when they go back home. You have AAU coaches, high school coaches, and then you have us. And a lot of times our language is different than everyone else's. So you have to listen to our language if we really want to succeed. So you have to cancel out all the noise. You can do that better when you're on campus or around your guys.
No doubt, Coach, and I feel like you did a good job getting guys who fit your system, because, you know, you got some older guys, some JUCO guys, some grad guys, and some young guys in that pipeline. Tell me about building that roster, having that balance of old and new, with enough guys in that pipeline to get in your coaching system that can grow to be older guys in a couple of years for you.
Well, the key for us is we brought back 5 starters from last year's team that ended the season when we put on that nice run of winning in 5 of our last 7. So we brought that core back. And then you add, like you said, you can kind of fill in holes and some gaps. The big thing about the transfer portal right now is that you can stay old. You never have to be really young. Now, you can be new. You can be a little inexperienced together, but you can also be older. And I think you know how it goes. When you get a little older, you're a little more mature. You've seen some of the things that are going to be thrown at you. You can handle adversity a little bit better. You know how to prepare yourself. It's just being older, it definitely helps. So for us, transfer portal and then mixing in some guys, some younger freshmen that can also learn from these older guys is very important. You got to have balance. So I think with the transfer portal and plus bringing in freshmen and some of those guys, it creates better balances for your team.
No doubt, Coach. And what I like about it is that you go on the road and beating Nebraska. Hopefully you'll get beat DePaul. Hopefully this on Saturday. You have a lot of guys from Chicago on your roster. I'll Midwest guys, guess what? They'll say, hey, Coach Jeter built some special over there in Macomb. Let me get them guys a chance now.
Yeah. And that's what you want. You want people to notice and you want people to respect what you do. And, you know, me being from the South Side of Chicago, we have a lot of other guys on our team from the Chicago South Side and Chicago area. So there's a lot of pride that goes into that. There's a lot of, you know, those old guys say, Wolf tickets that you be selling, you know, if you were able to win or if they beat you, you know, when you see guys back home, it just makes it fun. It's still the game of basketball, right? There's a lot of respect on both sides, but you just want to show up and compete and represent.
Most definitely, man. And for you, Coach, what's some young men you want to highlight who really had a great spring and summer? That our fans should look out for as you play DePaul and you keep playing this year. Who are some guys my listeners really watch out on your roster, man?
Yeah, well, I think the key new faces that we added, you know, one is Luka, our kid from Croatia, can really shoot the ball as a stretch big. You're looking at George Dixon, a kid from young man from Milwaukee. I've known George since he was, I think, seventh or eighth grade, played a few years at Eastern Illinois and then transferred to us. So that gives us some fillers. It fills some much needed gaps on the defensive side and shooting. But then you look at the returning guys too, right? You know, you've got Will Karius, who was an all-league player for us. He's playing really well. You got Tamel Pearson, who's gotten bigger, stronger, more acclimated to playing inside and out. And Colton Standage, who was a two-guard who had never played point guard, became our starting point guard those last 7-9 games where we really put on that run. To see those guys grow and mature is really special to watch that. And I can't forget about Trent Mazin, our new player for us, transfer from the Southland Conference. He was an all-league player there. Very big pickup for us. Now we have more balance out there on the guard position.
And, Coach, also, man, I love what you're doing because I tell you what, man, these young men had a COVID year. So last year, it didn't even kind of get eligibility. So, as you said, staying old is good. You get them an extra year now. Keep that core together a little while longer and be dangerous a year or two down the road, even still. Has to make you really excited in your staff.
Exactly. It is. And that's where in this offseason, our most critical recruit was a Will Karius, a kid that had already played 4 years and 5 years, and now he can come back and play again for a fifth, sixth year. So we did a nice job of making sure we had got that done. And you can just see his approach, his demeanor, doesn't rattle much. And it's good for our young guys like a KJ Lee, a true freshman out of St. Louis, to see that and kind of feed off of that. So, no, it's been good, man. And we're pretty blessed right now.
Most definitely. And, Coach, your non-conference schedule, so you got some tough mid-majors, got a DePaul Saturday, an Iowa on the road as well. So I feel like your young man has experienced that now. Going on to Iowa won't shake them, or going to a Northern Kentucky who was good in the Outer Horizon League won't shake them. Jack Owens coming to town next week with Miami Ohio, who beat Georgia Tech here in Atlanta on opening night. So playing teams like that won't shake your young men because they went to Nebraska, played a tough team on the road, pushing through that. I think your guys set up good for a non-conference and some elite play down the road, man.
Yeah, and you know, leading to that game, we talk about buying in, right? We talk about, you know, so we're young, we're a little inexperienced, but we have, you know, some new faces, and you have to get your team to buy in. That's the key to any success for any team, the buy-in. And sometimes what we see as coaches, players don't actually see that because they're not, their perspective is different. But in order to put it all together, they have to buy into your philosophies on offense. They got to sacrifice a little bit. They got to make sure they truly understand what you want them to do. And to really solidify that buy-in is when you have big wins like a Nebraska where they see it come together. It works. And now you can feed off that and build off of that. I think that was the biggest takeaway from that Nebraska game.
No doubt. Talk about the summer league itself, Coach. I know it's a tough league. You know, you guys are on the kind of eastern edge of the summer league, but it's pretty much that I-35 corridor right there, the middle of the country there. Tell me about how tough that league is to play, and about the quality of players and coaches in the league for my listeners out here who may not watch the summer league the way I do.
Yeah, what you know about that I-35 corridor up this way, man?
I know a little bit about it, Coach.
You know a little bit about it, but when you got a hat on down there, it's got to be warm down where you're at, right?
Hey, I'm down here in the basement, Coach. It's out in the basement. It's a little chilly down here, man.
Well, our league is a very physical league, right? It's I use the word like term buddy. It's a bully ball league. Meaning it's physical. The ball touches the post. You have systems that have been together for years. Head coaches that moved on, their assistants have taken over. So the system of how they want to play hasn't changed. All they're doing is just plugging in a new face, a new body. But they're still playing the exact same physical basketball. Pace is probably a little slower than some other parts of the country. So that means you have to defend. You're getting less opportunities to score. So you have to take care of the ball, and you have to make sure you can match the physicality. I think that sums up the Summit League, and the coaching is outstanding. So as you can see, we've had a chance to knock off some teams above our league. You know, our coaches are doing a fine job of taking care of their business.
Coach, I got two more for you about food. Chicago, when I come with the Hawks, see when they play the Bulls, right, where should I go get something to eat at when I get to the hotel, man?
Well, shoot, man, there's so many options, right? You know, you're a pizza guy, you know, you got to try some of those.
Pizza.
If you like ribs, you know, you've got Leon's and you've got Carson's Ribs, you know, some of those places, which is more of a chain, but it's still good. Man, you know, if you like Home Run In pizza, you know, you see all the chain stuff, but that's Chicago right there. You know, you got to try a little bit of that. I'm a big fan of the Italian beef sandwich. So,
okay.
You know, Portillo's is an easy spot to hit up, but yeah, there's so many food places that aren't chains that are good. They're just not rolling off my tongue right now. When I roll in town, it's quick and easy for me. I'm in and out.
I'm gonna text you at the time. I'm gonna say, hey, Coach, let me know where I need to go while I'm here, man.
I got you.
Now, when we come to my city, Atlanta,
yeah,
where do you go when you come to town? When you get off the airport, where do you go when you hear recruiting, going to Lake Point, the Peace Jam? That's trying to see fine players, period, here. A bunch of them down here. So tell me, where do you go?
Well, you know, I'm usually up there in Buckhead, right? I'm up in that area. There was a really nice soul food breakfast place on the way to the airport. So near Georgia State. I can't remember the place, but I usually try to find some of those things off of Yelp, you know, those hidden gems, you know, those 5-6 stars, you know, that you're trying to hit. I usually try to hit some of those places.
No doubt. I got some spots for you, Coach. Rays on the River, right. Copeland's, you know, American Deli, one of our ATL delicacies. Get your 10-piece wings and some fries. And
I like wings.
So, hey, Coach, we come to recruit, go to Lake Point, go to Peace Jam, Georgia Team Camp. I got you, Coach. Let me know, man.
I appreciate it, man. I appreciate that.
Coach, keep winning, man. Keep on going. I love you doing some successful stuff right now. Get that win in Chicago. DePaul is representing for Southside Chicago. Let them know what it's all about. What's going on, and the McComb boys out there coming to town, man.
Well, I appreciate it, man. Let me know when you're in the shy. I'll hook you up.
No doubt, Coach. I sure will, brother. Hey, you be safe, man.
Okay. Peace.
Peace now.
Yeah.